venture into the connected world of the internet. It's hard to imagine a place where so many apps and services don't cost a penny. Games, social networks, videos, music, pictures, it's like virtual paradise. But lurking underneath this wonderland, there is a far greater toll being collected: your identity. Names, locations, addresses, family, friendship connections, likes, searches, browsing history. Basically, the more of the internet you use, the more information you give corporations so that they can turn around and sell your identity to the highest bidder. Is there any way to be a part of this online economy without sacrificing your identity and privacy? Yes, you can lie. Here's the four major ways online companies collect your data and the four major ways you can hide your data from them. First is location. By using your computer's IP address, prying online services can determine where you're connecting to the internet from. A good practice is to hide your IP address using a proxy, or what's called a virtual private network. There are plenty of plugins for your specific browser type that allow you to do both. There's also free services out there such as CyberGhost that allow you to surf the web while hiding your IP address. You can also build your own VPN service using computers in different locations. Or you can pay for premium VPN services, which make it look like you're from a different country altogether. Second is site tracking and browsing history. When you visit certain websites, they collect data on you even if you aren't aware of it. I've already mentioned your IP address, but also your browser type, your operating system, what pages you visited, and what you click on. Depending on your browser, again, you can use different plugins that can block these websites from collecting information on you. Or you can use secure hardened web browsers, such as Tor or SRware Iron, which is like Chrome. Normally, if you want to use an online service, you have to sign up using personal information. But it doesn't necessarily have to be your personal information. That's where this third step comes into play: fake identities. If you go to fakenamegenerator.com, you can generate entire fake identities that you can use to fill out forms. Another good one is datafakegenerator.com that even lets you generate fake credit card numbers. Okay, last is the most important piece of information: your email address. This one's tricky because most online services require a valid email before you can complete the registration process. So you need a fake anonymous email that you can actually check. The best options to allow this are disposable email services such as 10-Minute Mail, Gorilla Mail, or Mailmesia for a longer-lasting fake email address. Although it's not 100% anonymity, these tips will at least get you 90% of the way there. I'd love to hear some of the methods that you guys use to stay hidden online. Let me know in the comments section. Click here to view last week's video tutorial and comment show, and if you enjoyed this video, please show your support by clicking here to subscribe, or feel free to visit our Google+, Facebook, and Twitter pages. Alright, that's it for this tutorial. Until next time, hack some fun into your weekend.